Hey everyone, I'm Tuff, and today we're going to talk about something that most people see every day, but rarely understand. We're diving into the world of rasterization, ray tracing, path tracing, and Lumen. And don't worry, no overcomplicated graphs, no tech overload. Just simple, clear explanations that actually make sense. And by the end of this video, I promise you'll understand not just how these techniques work, but why they matter and when they're used. Rendering, the process of turning data into a visual image, has been around since the earliest days of computer graphics. Back in 1968, a man named Arthur Appel created one of the first ray tracing techniques at IBM. It was groundbreaking. For the first time, computers were asked to simulate how light behaves. Then in 1986, James Kajiya introduced something even deeper, the rendering equation. And from that, path tracing was born. This was light simulation on a whole new level. Honestly, it's kind of wild thinking about this. If Arthur Appel or James Kajiya had dropped ray tracing or path tracing back in the 1600s, they wouldn't be presenting at SIGGRAPH. They'd be burned at the stake for witchcraft.
What do you mean? The light bounces.
Let's bring it back to something a little less medieval and a lot more familiar, because the first rendering method most of us actually experienced wasn't magic, it was rasterization. So let's start with rasterization. If you've played almost any game before 2019, this is what powered it. Rasterization takes a 3D world made of models, textures, lights, and projects it onto a 2D screen. It turns triangles into pixels. It colors them in based on the light in the scene. But here's the thing. Rasterization isn't really showing you real lighting. Most of it is just clever tricks. Shadows? They're usually just dark textures placed on the ground. Reflections? Often just screenshots of the scene flipped. And light bouncing around? It's not actually bouncing. But why we use it? Because it's fast. It's efficient. And for decades, it was the only way to get smooth gameplay. Games like Fortnite, Galerant, Call of Duty, they all run on rasterization. Because when reaction time matters, speed wins over realism. But visuals? That's where ray tracing comes in. Ray tracing changed the game, literally. Instead of faking how light behaves, ray tracing simulates it. Imagine a camera inside the game. For every pixel on the screen, a ray of light is cast into the scene. That ray might hit a wall, bounce to a floor, reflect off a window, and finally come back to your eye. Or in this case, the screen. That's why you see accurate reflections in puddles, real-time shadows that blur naturally, ambient lighting that feels alive. Games like Alan Wake 2 use ray tracing for all of this. But even then, they don't ray trace everything. It's too expensive for real-time gameplay. So they combine it with rasterization. A hybrid. You get the beauty of light simulation with the speed of rasterization. Now let's go deeper into path tracing, where ray tracing fires one ray per pixel, path tracing fires hundreds. It tracks every bounce of light, every soft shadow, every color that reflects onto another surface. For example, here I have my basic project in Blender, and I'm using the Cycles render engine, which uses path tracing. If I switch from solid shading view to render view, you'll see it's calculating thousands of rays in the scene. Now, if I were using Eevee, it would have rendered instantly and shown the result in real time, but my project isn't optimized for Eevee, so sorry about that. Still, I think you get the idea. So yeah, ray tracing tries to be smart about light, but path tracing? It's just like, I'll do it properly, even if it takes forever. Now, games like Cyberpunk 2077 and Alan Wake 2, they say they're using path tracing. But here's what's really happening. They're giving you the look of a path-traced scene without actually doing all the crazy math behind it. It's more like ray tracing in disguise, dressed up with some smart tricks to look like full path tracing, but light enough to still run in real time. Basically, it's like giving you the movie lighting vibe without your PC catching fire. Now, let's talk about Lumen. Lumen isn't ray tracing, it's not path tracing either. It's kind of a mix. A smart system built to make lighting look realistic, but still run in real time. Imagine walking into a dark cave with a torch. In older games, the cave would stay dark because lighting was baked. With Lumen, the moment the light moves, the bounce light reacts instantly. Shadows shift, surfaces glow realistically. No pre-baking, no waiting. Lumen uses screen space tracing, distance fields, and smart software to simulate light in a way that feels real, but runs at real-time speed. Is it accurate like path tracing? No, but it's fast, flexible, and creative-friendly. Let's do a quick recap of where each one shows up. Rasterization, used in almost every competitive shooter and fast-paced game. Ray tracing, found in high-end games like Cyberpunk 2077 for reflections, shadows, and lighting. Path tracing, used in films and VFX, for example, The Lion King, 2019. Lumen, ideal for real-time open-world games that want dynamic, believable lighting without the cost of full simulation. And in the end, every game developer chooses based on what matters most: frame rate, realism, or atmosphere. Some studios don't release games, they release trailers. If the lighting looks good for 5 seconds in a pre-launch screenshot, they're done. Bugs? Gameplay? Who cares? They're path tracing their way to your wallet. Now here's the part most people don't realize. If they can trace the path from their wallet to my wallet by going to my Ko-fi page, we'll both experience some real-time happiness. Buy me a coffee. It powers the render and the rant. Lumen, ray tracing, and path tracing, they all come from the same idea. They're all trying to answer one question: how light behave in a 3D space? The only difference is how they approach it. Path tracing goes all in, simulate every bounce, every photon. Ray tracing simplifies it, simulate just enough to make it look good. Lumen estimates, simulate what matters, fake the rest, but make it feel right. They're not different philosophies, they're different compromises, and that's the beauty of rendering. Behind every reflection, every glow, every shadow is a decision, a balance. You don't need to be an expert to appreciate it. You just need to see the light. I don't usually break things down like this, but let me explain the difference between ray tracing and path tracing in the simplest way possible. Here, I've got a light source, a tree, and a camera. The camera, in a game, is basically your eyes. Whatever it sees is what shows up on your screen. There's a light source. It sends out one ray into the scene. That ray hits the tree, then it bounces off the ground. After bouncing, it finally reaches the camera. The camera takes that bounced ray and figures out what color to show on your screen. That's ray tracing. One ray per pixel. It bounces, reflects, and carries light info back to the camera. That's how it creates realistic lighting and reflections. Now let's talk about path tracing. It works kind of like ray tracing, but on a much bigger scale. Instead of sending just one ray per pixel, path tracing sends out tons of rays, sometimes hundreds, sometimes thousands, all for a single pixel. These rays bounce around the scene, hitting walls, objects, floors, and other surfaces. And here's the important part: every bounce collects light information. All those little rays keep bouncing until the computer has enough information to figure out what that one pixel should really look like. The result? A much more realistic image. That's why path tracing is used in movies and CGI. It's not fast, but it's accurate. Path tracing doesn't guess. It simulates light like it actually behaves in the real world. All right, if you still don't understand what these rendering pipelines are, honestly, I don't know how much simpler I can explain it. But hey, maybe now, next time someone says path tracing or Lumen or RTX ON, you'll at least know they're not just making up fancy words.